What's up, YouTube? So today I decided to make a video, a quick update on my 20-gallon tank. Now, for those that have been subscribed to my channel and seen my recent videos I've uploaded to this channel, you can tell this tank has a quite different look from past videos. These green mushrooms that on the left side are new. This gold torch right here, that's a new addition, and the one in the back. Now the reason why I don't have the hammer coral that was in here, I had quite a few hammer corals. One was right here. It was a 16 head, and I had quite a few on the side, green. There were green hammers. Now the reason why they're not in here is because of this bad boy right here. He just loves to nip. He just loves to nip on every single coral except for torches and mushrooms. That's the only thing he doesn't like to nip. Yep. Now this tank has been set up for about a year and 2 months, I believe. I mean, this thing it's been going on. Parameters, pH, everything's stabilized. Now the only time I've had a problem with it was, I'd say, 6 months ago. When I was doing a water change. Now whenever I do a water change or top it off with fresh water, you know how salt water evaporates and the salt stays in, and you just have to top it off with fresh water, which I do, but I don't use ROD water. I just use water from the faucet, you know. Now luckily the water that comes out of the faucet is acceptable. I mean, I've been doing that for the year, and look at this. Haven't had a problem. I guess it just depends on what state you live. And in case you didn't know where I live in Texas. Yeah, everything's bigger in Texas. But anywho, 6 months ago I was doing a water change, and instead of doing the routine thing I do, getting water from the faucet in the kitchen, I went into the bathroom and got water from there, and I did a water change with that water. And days passed, a couple of weeks, and all my corals started to look all crappy and shit. And then I didn't know what to do. I just sat down, stared at my tank, and tried to come up with the logical conclusion on what happened, you know? And just snapped, and I was like, oh, okay, I think I know what happened. It was that day that I did a water change using the water from the bathroom. That's crazy how, you know, how things work. But anyway, this is a 20-gallon tall tank. The way I have it set up is I have two hang-on filters in the back, one power head, and I have a customized sump. It's a 10-gallon sump. It's down here in the bottom. Now, as you can see how it's set up, it's just all ghetto looking. Now the way it's like this, it's because I was just testing it whenever I made it. Days passed, weeks, months, and it's up running, and I never had a problem with it. This side I have a BioCube protein skimmer. In the back I have a power head to keep all the debris from piling up and flushing all the way over here to the refugium. some chittamorphin. Okay, sorry about that, guys. My phone ran out of space and I had to delete some videos on it. But anyways, okay, the water comes through here, power head, same to keep the debris from piling up there. Now, and I have a return pump that goes back up to the tank. And that's how this tank is set up. Now, if you're wondering what did I do with the hammer corals and the other corals that I had in here, I did another tank, as you can see the reflection on it. All right, let's check that out. And here it is.